day two, I want you to set up your 3X slide with all of the blocks on the outer ring. And I want you to start by only having on your right shoe cover. So I'm going to take off my left shoe cover here. I'm going to put my heel right up against the back blocks here, which is now my 6 o'clock block. And I'm going to start with my right foot going out towards my 1 o'clock block. So I'm going to hit my toe to my 1 o'clock block. My hands are going to drive towards my knee, and I'm going to pull back up nice and tall. The way that we can adjust this exercise, if you need to make it a little bit smaller, is you're just going to step your left foot in just a little bit so that you can make the distance a little shorter. Because what I really want you guys to focus on is to be able to have your hips squared up to your 12 o'clock block, and you're sliding out to that 1 o'clock block, getting a little opening up of that hip. You're controlling the motion going out, and then you're controlling that motion coming back in. All right, as you're dragging that foot back in, you're working on all those muscles again, all the stabilizing muscles, and even in your stationary leg is working really hard to get you back up, standing up tall. This is where you're gonna be using your core, even though I don't want you to focus on your core, but I also want you to notice if you're having to arch your back to get up, then your distance to the block is much too far. Okay, so we've gone to your 1 o'clock block, and now you're gonna go straight ahead to your 12 o'clock block. Now, your base of support is a little bit narrower, so your balance is gonna be challenged a little bit more. And so I want you to go slow the first couple of times. Again, we're aiming towards the middle of that 12 o'clock block. I want your weight to shift forward. I want your back leg to stay straight. Your heel can come off the ground a little bit. I'm gonna just turn so that you can see it. My heel can come off the ground a little bit, but this knee, really, I want it to stay as straight as it can. And you're sliding forward. Your weight is shifting forward. We're loading up this butt. And then you're working hard to stand back up tall. So you're using those hamstrings, and you're pulling yourself back up. So that is your second one. So we're done with that. And now you're gonna keep that toe really straight, and I'm gonna cross my body with my right foot to get over there. So I'm gonna go across to my 11 o'clock block and really lean in. What you're gonna notice is that this heel wants to cheat out. I really want you to keep that heel and that toe pointing to your 12 o'clock block. So if the distance is too far, then you can do two things. One, you can move your left foot, your stationary foot, in a little bit so that the distance isn't so far, or you can just go to the left side of that 12 o'clock block. So I moved my left foot in, and so now it's not quite as hard for me to reach over across my body, where I'm really working on some hip motion here and some glute activation to get over to that block and to be able to stand back up nice and tall again. All right, good work. So that was the first three. So now all you're gonna do is switch. So I want you to take off that shoe cover, and you're gonna put it on your left foot. And now you may notice that you have a difference in your legs and which one is stronger. So I want you to have your right heel placed against your 6 o'clock block, and you're gonna start by going out with your left foot to your 11 o'clock block. Now again, remember, if that distance feels too far, if you feel too challenged, if it feels too wobbly, you're gonna just step that stationary foot in a little bit. And now I'm gonna slide out to my 11, slide it back up. Slide out to my 11, slide it back up. Great work. And the whole time you're just in control of this motion. You're controlling out, and you're controlling on the way back. You're gonna slide and push your foot into the floor, into the board the whole time, so that you're really working hard to control that motion all the way out, and working hard to control it all the way back up, and using a lot more muscles to do it, right? We talked about, now we're gonna go forward to 12, about your muscles never really getting a break on this, because we are constantly engaging them as they're after sliding through this motion. So you're just getting more bang for your buck doing it this way, and we're able to have an environment for you to be able to train safely and effectively, because I can tell you exactly where we want you to get to, why we want to get there, and the whole time you're doing it in this low impact environment. All right, so out to 12 and slide it on back. Out and slide it on back. Okay, and now we're gonna cross our body again to our 1 o'clock block. So if that distance feels too far, again, just move your stationary foot a little bit further forward and make sure that your toes are pointing to your 12 o'clock block, and then you're gonna cross your body and bring it on home. And cross your body and come on back up nice and tall. Good, and all you should be focused on is getting that toe across to your 1 o'clock block, keeping your stationary toe pointed towards your 12. If you feel like it's cheating out, that's okay. We're just working on getting you a little more hip motion there. And so you just wanna put it back, replace it, get it going forward again, and then continue on with that exercise. Reach it around, bring it on back. Reach it around, bring it on back. All right, perfect. Okay, now that we have our left shoe cover on, we are going to put our right heel back up against our 6 o'clock block, and I want you to go out towards your 11 o'clock block, lead with the side of your foot this time, and then bring it on back home. And lead with the side of your foot, and bring it on back home. So again, this is just another way we're looking for a little bit more motion. We're trying to get this hip to turn in. We're trying to get this hip to stretch out here in the back. All of these exercises trying to get your pelvis to rotate and shift and turn, because all of your core muscles are attached to your pelvis. All of your pelvic floor muscles are attached to your pelvis. If we can keep your pelvis moving, we can keep all those muscles engaged and turn on. Okay, so the next one is, I want you to do the same thing, but we're gonna get all the way out to our 12 o'clock block and turn that foot in. So this is really challenging for me. I have tight hips, so I'm gonna move this foot up a little bit more. And now I'm gonna slide and get that left foot right up against that 12 o'clock block. Again, chest up, head up, eyes up, coming forward, hitting that block as squarely as I can, watching that this foot isn't cheating out this way, because this becomes a very different exercise, right? I wanna make sure that this toe is pointed towards my 12 o'clock block, just sliding, hitting it nice and squarely, and bringing it back home. You're gonna feel those hips working. Good, you got your core turning on. You may even feel little muscles in your feet working hard. Keep your balance. All right, I'm gonna switch. I'm gonna put my other shoe cover back on. Take this one off so that I can have one really stable foot. Okay, so I'm gonna start by having my left heel up against my 6 o'clock block, and my right foot is going up to my one. I'm gonna turn and hit it really square, right up against it. Let that hip bump out a little bit. Make sure that my stable foot is pointing towards my 12 o'clock block. Eyes up, chin up, chest up. Aiming for the goal of that 1 o'clock block, nice and solid. Remember, pushing into the ground the whole time. Push into the ground and then drag it on back. Push into the ground, drag it on back. All right, now I'm gonna move up to my 12, and for me, I'm gonna take a little bit of a half step forward so that I can be closer to that 12, so that I can really get all the way around. So I'm gonna get all the way around, making sure that my left toe is facing that block. I wanna get all the way around. come on back. Get all the way around and come on back. This is a challenging motion for those hips. You're gonna do the best you can. If you need to stand up even closer, you may need to get nice and close and turn, just so that you can hit the outside of your foot up to that 12 o'clock block. I don't care where your stable foot is, we just really wanna start to promote that motion, being able to get those hips really turning, get that pelvis really turning. Let's turn on all those muscles that attach to our pelvis. Pelvis, big rock of the body, right? It's where everything starts, everything below, and then everything going on up. We need to make sure it's functioning effectively. All right, good work. That's exercise, or day two. Exercise is complete. 10 more minutes.